All right, just got back from Jared Taylor's house yesterday, planning out some content with Black Rifle. It's going to be pretty awesome. And now it's time to hit the airport again to go film season 3 of Wine Rations. So head to Montana. This will be the first time it's going to be snowing out there. So hopefully we don't get stuck. But, yeah, there's the luggage again. Luckily, I stole that from Jared's house, so I'm going to need that.
So it's 4 in the morning and I'm headed to Ontario Airport. I just got everything loaded in the truck and ready to go. Taking everything I need pretty much for Wine and Rations. So I've got the lights, the cameras, and anything else that we might need to shoot this show. Kind of sucks because this time I don't have Tom and Kurt to help me out with loading and taking care of all this stuff when I land. So time to hop on this plane. I guess I'll see you guys in Montana.
Good old Montana. You know what? Living in Texas, like the snow is pretty sick now. I didn't think I'd miss it.
So we just got the text from Nick Bear. He wants to say January 10th, but what day works for us for January 10th, Abel? I've been getting my shit together when it comes to coffee, but I didn't bring anything to make my own coffee because I've been doing the pour over and it's incredible. And then I take the leftover of the pour over and I put it in the fridge. So that way at like noon, I could have a delicious iced coffee. And it's been so great. It's like therapeutic in the morning for me to make it. And I didn't bring anything. So now I got this.
Therapeutic.
I'm serious. Fuck you. Like taking the time to make the coffee right is therapeutic. It's relaxing. And then I write my book. But now I have this and drip coffee, but whatever. We'll make it work.
Conducting business.
We actually are.
Trisha Mosen. Abel is sending some emails on our behalf, on my behalf. I'm a big celebrity now. I don't handle my own emails. I don't take care of that stuff. I think it's kind of a cool option though. It's somebody wants us to do a video for their video game. I'd much prefer a character in the video game.
Be a character, a playable character?
Yeah.
And they can be Sean Buck Rogers?
Yeah.
And like your kit and everything?
Yeah, they have my kit. They'll do that. They'll play with the guns. I want a beat off option.
A lot of people said, how did you let him do the same choke over and over and over again? Like, didn't you learn?
Tim Kennedy wasn't happy with you.
He wasn't happy with me.
What did he say?
He said, if you wanted Green Beret to roll with, why don't you call me out? I'm like, well, I'm not stupid, and I've rolled with you before, so that's not great content for me.
So that's the cue.
Yeah.
SBG Montana. This one's in Whitefish, though. Different one than the last time. Both, like, super nice facilities. This place is sweet. This time I'm hoping to not get destroyed the whole time. Maybe I actually learn something instead of just getting choked out 14 times?
Is it 13 times.
13 times. All right.
Make sure everybody knew how many times you got.
No, I'm not talking shit. Look at him. He wants it. He wants me to talk shit. Nice to me, so I appreciate that, because I'm hurting. It's hard. I wish I was better. Can you just like purchase better skills? That would be nice. I would spend that money.
Like Instagram followers?
Yeah. Just buy skill points.
Just like buy skill points.
He gets all excited. Gosh,
damn. You can play tough. You know your rib is injured, so you play tough. You can do passing.
Okay.
But what position feels the most comfortable?
I don't know. I'll figure it out as you go. See, he's got me worried about it. So we can switch it up and do something else.
Yeah,
that was
pulled him out.
That was bad before my rib injury. I'm not using rib injury as an excuse because I would have got murdered the same. It just hurts more now.
So I tried to go super slow.
No, you did. Yeah. It was not you, dude. I just out of practice. And rib injuries suck, man. This is my first like real one.
That's how you did that.
How was that, sir?
It was good. That was a lot funner than the last iteration that we had. But we're just having a fucking blast marathon day where we met up for breakfast. We had breakfast. Now we're doing jiu-jitsu. This dickhead. We're doing jiu-jitsu. Now we're going to go do a podcast for Clear to Hot. And then we're going to go film a wine rations. There's always somebody in the comment section that's maybe from that country or has experiences that'll let you know. So I'm going to try.
All right. So we just finished up the third season of Wine and Rations, where Sean largely eats disgusting food. So what I told him last season was, come out and I'll cook you some better food. So I had a guy on the podcast named Jeff Smith. He is the founder of Colorado Craft Beef. Let me make sure that's the exact words. Yep. So Jeff Smith, Colorado Craft Beef, he's awesome. He sends meat. So both of these are from his ranch in Colorado, just for clarity. It's not a fake name. I go very simple on the seasoning. I'm going to be cooking all of this on the Traeger. Traeger is a pellet grill. You can do a lot of smoking, but oftentimes I just crank the thing up to high. And I don't know about you guys, I go with like a medium at best, probably medium rare.
Oh, medium rare for sure.
For red meat. Yeah. The Traeger beef rub is amazing, which these have on there. And then I also will do the Saskatchewan, the blackened Saskatchewan, just a touch of it. And then I also do the veggies on the Traeger as well. We have broccoli, Brussels sprouts. I trim this up before and I kind of guzzle it with olive oil. And then what I'll do is I'll lay them each out in a container that I can cook on the Traeger after I pull the meat while it's resting. I like the pork and poultry, the green one. It's gluten and carb free. Mm. Apple and honey is just to disguise and confuse people.
Mm.
So that's it. Meat goes on probably 10 minutes max being on there. These will be on for 5 to 10 minutes, and then the easiest meals you've ever had. Dishes are a piece of cake.
Do you prep? Is there like a lot of prep for the Traeger? Like, you just get the cold burn.
While we were filming the last episode, I went and turned it on just to make sure it got up to 500 degrees, the top end temperature of that thing. That's it.
The time of my life. So anyway, now we're going to eat good food. We wrapped another season, and this is what we do. So we'll plan in a couple months. We'll plan to get back to Montana and to do more. And keep an eye out, because I think we're going to try and figure out how to do another show, which is going to be super fun and super beneficial, because Montana's a shit and Andy and I make some pretty damn good shows.
I'm going to take this out in case you guys are ever wondering how we're doing this on the technical side. I mean, maybe one day I'll make an actual full video if you guys want it, but we went pretty minimalistic on this one. I don't have the help of Tom and Kurt, which I usually do, and we have a gimbal and the camera set up on that, and we usually take turns holding it and filming from that right side or left side, depending on, you know, how you're looking at it. But this time I went with a camera slider, and I went with just one dome light. So I have even light. You don't want harsh light on people. This one's just sort of a fill-in light, just a filler, just to make sure that everything is lit up good on that left side. And that's it. That's all we have going. We have one food cam on that right side, and then we have the main camera that was sliding. I'm actually holding it now. And it was super efficient, super good, and it worked out pretty well.
Just cut up the meat, and then I'm gonna grab the veggies, and then it's dinner time.
Do you think it'd be fun to do?
All right, so in a fun little turn of events, we're stuck in Kalispell for another day because there's severe windstorms in Denver. Oh yeah, by the way, you guys, I know this is the next day. We finished up all that stuff at Andy's house yesterday.
Yeah, so we had an awesome day yesterday, and then today we're like, sweet, we're going to just get the heck out of here, get some lunch, and then head out. And then we started getting blown up on our phones that there's hurricane-level winds, like 80 miles to 100-mile-an-hour winds in Denver today. So we changed our flights, and now we're just going to create content all day and figure out what we could think of and try to take advantage of the time, because we need to do as much as possible. Those things even for? They're like, they unfold and they have like straps on them.
Yeah.
Like it couldn't even fit.
Oh, for the suitcase.
Yeah, they couldn't even fit my body. I was like laying on it, stiff as a board. So, and then I was like, and then check for bad guys, and then jumping, like pulling myself out from under the bed and shit.